What's up, guys and girls? Welcome back to the channel. I hope everyone had a blessed Christmas and hopefully a happy new year. I'm definitely looking forward to the new year, so I'm actually quite excited for the new year. Can't wait to get everything up and running, finish up some project cars. For now, I want to introduce you guys to my new daily driver. Okay, so it's a four-door EF Honda Civic, or Ballard. In South Africa, it's called the Ballard. I know in America, most other parts of the world, it's called the Civic. And this is what you call a proper sleeper. Well, I call it the wolf in sheep's clothing. So it's an unfinished project I bought from a friend. Unfortunately, he didn't get the opportunity to even drive the car. To stand in his shed at his workshop, and then eventually I bought it from him. So we had a couple of issues with the car. Like firstly, when I viewed it at first, it could start up, and eventually when I purchased the car, it couldn't start at all. And we eventually figured out the issue with the car, managed to sort it out, and now it starts up and drives. So what I'm basically doing now is tackling the suspension on the car, so sorting out all suspension bits on the car and so on, so it can drive much safer and better. Let me show you guys what's under the hood. K28-2. It's a completely stock swap with a transmission. It's got a lot of fancy bits on it: K-tune fuel rail, K-tune fuel pressure regulator, braided fuel lines, custom radiator, Mishimoto radiator hoses, stock intake, carships alternator relocator, chase bays, brake booster delete kit. Yeah, the engine bay is pretty decent, but I am probably going to redo everything. So redo the fuel lines, redo the clutch line, as well as the brake lines. I mean, at least it's pretty decent, but I'd prefer to clean it up even nicer, redo the engine bay, and then probably give the car a blowover as well. But it has on the engine bay compartment all the essentials. So I mean, even the wiring is neatened up nicely. It's got a custom traction bar on there as well. I swapped out the header that was on the car for a DTR header. Apparently this header is the old header from the IPG CRX in the US. Bought it recently from a friend, and it's got a nice 76mm one box exhaust system, 3-inch exhaust system. Swapped out the rear LCAs, obviously because of the coilovers that are fork type. It's K-tuned coilovers. This is normally rear LCAs were like pillow ball. So car has like minimal rust on it. Just a couple of rust spots here and there on the fender at the bottom over there, and above the roof there, small dots, which is perfect. Like, we can have that redone and blow the car over, repair all the dings and stuff on the fender, and then obviously get all the missing panels and stuff from the car. So I know there's a beading missing on the passenger side fender, and then on the interior there's a couple of bits missing. So like I said, the previous owner, he unfortunately didn't get the chance to finish off the car, and we basically taking it from there and finishing it up. Show you guys the interior. So I do plan on keeping this car full interior. I want to make it like a proper street car. So yeah, like I said, there's a couple of bits missing here and there. We'll collect that at the later stage. But the interior is very decent. I mean, this we can obviously clean up and so on. There's the ECU over there, K-tune shifter. So on the wire inside, I know it's pretty messed up here, but I'll probably just redo everything. So in the meantime, I I rode you in the car and I ended up taking my CRX's 550's Nano, just so we have a wideband. The car obviously didn't come with a wideband, so the car is like somewhat tuned. It drives pretty well, it's light on fuel, and this car pulls. Like, for a car with full interior, that's a four-door, this car is pretty lightweight. I think, if I'm not mistaken, it weighs like 950, so 950 kilograms, under a ton. I'm sure it's much lighter because there's a lot of bits and pieces that was missing from the car, like climate control, the heater core, all that's all taken out. So this is like a proper weekend warrior. It's got power windows, all the windows work. I mean, even the rear demister still works on the rear windscreen. So this is quite a fun project. It's gonna be nice to like neaten it up, tidy it up, make the car look presentable. I mean, like I said, this car is a proper sleeper. Like, nobody would expect there's a K-swap in this car from the outside. And also, it's not too loud. Obviously, when you put your foot down, it's quite loud. VTEC definitely comes in with a bang. But yeah, we'll take it for a drive, give you guys a little experience of what it drives like. Just bear with me, there is a bit of noises here and there. It is obviously an old car, and obviously most of you guys know the infamous clutch pedal noise. But yeah, I'm enjoying myself with this car. Okay, so we're just on the little secluded road. It's my friend Liam over here. Yes. And we're gonna get his
feedback.
Give some feedback from his perspective.
But we are sitting in the passenger seat, it's a bit not scary, but actually feel much safer driving. Not a very good passenger.
Seatbelt on?
Yeah.
So we just got back and I'm gonna maybe just interview Liam here and just get his like input on what he thinks this car is like, if let's just say it were to be his daily driver. What's your experience?
Yeah, look, for a daily driver, it's definitely doable, put it that way, but you need to be very disciplined in that sense, because anytime, I'll say trigger happy, but you can get
into a lot of trouble.
Yeah. You need a lot of trouble, yeah. But otherwise, it rolls nice, it moves. It's not the first case swap or thing I drove. So, I mean, for someone maybe that doesn't know the power, you can get yourself into trouble. But definitely, for a daily, a sleeper, that's a sleeper. Definitely a lot of fun. I would definitely, if you buy the means and you can have a daily like this, then why not? Lekker. I mean, it's got full interior in, so it's not like you get in like a lot of guys strip out and you get in, it's all this thin sound and get all that, but I mean, there's still sound deadening, everything is in there, so I mean, it's lekker. Yeah, but yeah. Lekker. I mean, definitely a lot of fun. Anyone would want a K in the garage. Like, okay, I mean, I drive a code, but if you compare the power to weight, big difference.
Big
so
difference,
definitely yeah. A lot of fun. I mean, oh, I would even take this car to a track. It was by the, like I say, a track car would be perfect, actually. Just to get fun with, if not out on the road, causing havoc.
Okay, so that was just a little short clip of the new daily driver. So yeah, like I mentioned earlier, there is still quite a few bits and pieces that still need to be installed on the car. So for instance, the bearing is missing, the fuel filler cap is missing, as well as the panels on the interior side. And then we'll just tackle the front suspension, do the bushings on the front lower control arms, and then I might just add actually the secondary arms on the traction bar, just to keep the lower control arm fixed to the subframe. And then we'll redo the engine bay, brake lines, fuel lines, and then maybe close up all the excess holes and then shave the bay a bit, and then blow the entire car over and make it look clean and neat. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll definitely catch you guys soon.